Sherry here, and I am back today to do my 20-week update. Oh my goodness, I cannot believe that today I am 20 weeks pregnant. That is just so mind-blowing to me. I'm halfway done with this pregnancy. I'm halfway to meeting Anaya. Like, I just can't believe that I am 20 weeks pregnant. Like, I feel like I was just telling you guys that I'm 9 weeks pregnant. It's pretty crazy that time flew by that fast. I'm just gonna talk about my symptoms. I'm gonna get started. Okay, so tomorrow I have another doctor's appointment. I actually don't know why I have doctor appointments so frequently. I'm not high risk. I'm not, you know, nothing's wrong. So I actually don't know. And I think in 4 weeks I have to do my glucose test. So I'm not excited for that at all. I'm just gonna jump into some symptoms really quick. Symptoms that I've had this week really are really noticeable is that I get like this sharp pain like around my vagina. Like, I know that's probably TMI, but
this is a pregnancy vlog on a mommy channel, so I mean
TMI, but I really do get like a sharp stabbing pain like right around my vagina. I asked my baby board about it and they said a lot of women were like, yeah, I get it too, blah blah blah, so I'm not the only one that's getting it. Another weird symptom that I've been having is I grow a lot of hair on my belly. And I know last week I told you guys that I get a lot of hair, but this week I'm getting a lot of hair. More symptom that I've been having is I've been running out of breath more frequently now, and I notice it a lot. Even just doing like small things like going up my stairs, and you know, I have Isaiah who's almost 2 years old, chasing him around is Anaya moves around a lot. Like, she is constantly on the move. Like, sometimes I feel her kicks like right here. Like, sometimes I feel her kicks right here, and then sometimes I'll feel her kicks down here, like down here, so in my lower belly. It's really like, it's cool, but it's just weird because I feel like I was just going through that with Isaiah, and now Anaya's doing it. But to be honest, Anaya's totally different from how Isaiah was at this point. Like, seriously, the patterns, like, I remember, because it wasn't long ago when I had Isaiah, sadly. So, I remember everything about Isaiah and when I was pregnant with him and everything. And the pattern of his kicks were totally different from Anaya's. Like, Anaya's real, like, she's up at nighttime. She's ready to go. She's up. She's kicking me. She's like, hey, get your butt up, mom. Walk around. Put me back to sleep. Isaiah, on the other hand, he played all day and went to sleep at night, which is what he did from the time he was in my stomach all the way up until now. Hopefully this little girl doesn't stay on the same schedule that she has in my belly, or either she switches her schedule up and becomes more alert in the daytime and stays sleep through the nighttime. Another thing that I wanted to go ahead and address is I will not be breastfeeding Anaya. This is just my personal choice because I've been breastfeeding Isaiah for 19 months. I'm still breastfeeding him. He's still breastfed. I don't want to breastfeed anymore. Like, I know that that sounds so selfish and like, I don't know, just selfish, but this is just a parenting choice that I have decided. I talked with Dresden because he's, you know, a breastfeeding advocate. He wants me to breastfeed. But this is something that I've just decided because breastfeeding puts so much on my body. And, you know, if you've never had a kid or you have a child on the way, at least try breastfeeding. Like, don't just knock it for no reason. At least try it. I feel like that's what you should do. I'm all for breastfeeding. But breastfeeding for me just puts so much on my body. It's so hard to wean Isaiah from breastfeeding. And then I have this new baby who I would be trying to breastfeed. And I just don't want to deal with that stress. And I feel like if a mom's not mentally there, then she's not going to be mentally there with her kids neither. So I feel like I'm looking out for the best of Anaya, the best of myself, and the best of Isaiah. If I just don't breastfeed her, I'm not even going to nurse her after she's born. She'll be going straight to the bottom. If you guys want to tell me some formula that you had for your kids that and they liked it, go ahead and leave it down below and let me know. I'm just gonna show you guys my belly really quick. Okay, so this is from the front. No, that was from the side. This is from the front. Then from the side. Dresses kind of make you look bigger too, so. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Don't forget to let me know what formula that you tried on your kids. Let me know what bottles that you used. If you, whether you breastfed or you formula fed, let me know what bottles that you used so I could look into them. And I will see you guys for my next video. Bye.